Hey everyone, in this video we're going to be talking about something a bit more technical. We're going to be talking about how the import and catalog functions work together in Zoner Photo Studio X. And specifically, we're going to be talking about how to use the catalog, take advantage of it when importing your photos into Zoner Photo Studio X. So let's get started. All right, so something to keep in mind is that you can use import without needing to use the catalog function. And you can also use the catalog functions without using the import. It's standard philosophy here at Zoner Photo Studio X that the software is created to cater to your needs, not the other way around. So you can create your workflow based on what you need and what suits you best without needing to do exactly what the software wants you to do. So before importing photos, you need to look at your catalog structure. By default, you have one folder in your catalog, which is the pictures folder, and you can add other folders to catalog, of course, if you want. If you have one folder, it's easier to navigate, but you have to have the same settings for all the subfolders and images in terms of preloading. The other option is to have multiple folders with different settings for each folder in the catalog. And I'll show you why that is useful. For example, if I have a folder in my catalog with personal pictures containing, let's say, vacation or family photos, for these photos, let's say that I want all the newly added photos to be preloaded. We then save time processing them in the develop module when we preload them. On the other hand, there are times, say, we have portraits or product photos, and we end up with a huge amount of images, and a vast majority of those aren't going to be used at all. Therefore, it doesn't make sense to preload all these images when adding them to the catalog. They're not going to load as fast in the develop module, but that's okay because I'm only going to edit a small number of them. And it's not about what works best in this particular situation, but I just wanted to show you what the options are and different ways that you can use Zoner Photo Studio X. So don't take this as something written in stone that you have to do, but rather as something you can take as an inspiration. Now let's take a look at how to customize a catalog. Click your Zoner account, select Preferences, and then go to the Catalog tab. Here you can see the folders you have in the catalog. There's always one folder by default, which is the pictures folder, as we mentioned earlier. And of course, you can add more folders. For example, I'll add a folder dedicated to client photographs. Let's click on the Add Folder button, find the folder on my hard drive that we want, and then select or click Select Folder. The idea is that I have this folder that I also want to add to the catalog. So I can use quick filtering and search by the number of stars or keywords. At the same time, I want to keep these photos separate from my pictures folder, which has different settings because I know that I'm going to delete many of these new photos and I'm not going to be working with them at all. For this reason, I have different settings for these photos than those that are in my pictures folder. For my pictures folder, I select Preload Smart RAWs. And so if I add pictures to this folder in the catalog in the future, Zoner will preload the images so that they're faster to work with in the develop module. Remember, this setting is useful if you plan to continue editing most of the photos. Whereas for my other folder, the client photos I made, I chose the preload fast previews for develop option. The name of this folder refers to the files already edited. But the main thing is that unlike the first folder, there is no preloading for the develop module. Because as I said, from the entire bunch of client photos, I'm only going to edit a very select few. And then I'll wait for them to load in the develop module. With the catalog set up this way, I can show you what import looks like. So I apply my settings. Then I click the import button, which is found here on the bottom left. And I'll wait for Zoner Photo Studio X to load all the files from the card or the other source, which I can select right here in the top right. As mentioned earlier, I'm going to demonstrate this using some client photos. I'm only interested in the photos from this specific photo shoot, so I will not select or I will unselect all the photos and then select only the photos from a specific date. At the same time, I still need to choose where to save the photos. And since I've added a new folder to the catalog, which is client, I'll select that one. With my import settings complete, when I click copy, my photos are copied to my computer. And now we can see how Zoner Photo Studio X quickly indexes the newly added photos. I can check this by clicking the client folder and opening the subfolder for a specific date. I see all the photos there with the thumbnail immediately loaded. I can now go through the photos, sort them, rate them using stars or the color labels, whatever you prefer, and then I'll work on editing the photos I selected in the develop module. And that's it for today. I hope that was a handy tip for how to use the catalog when you're importing your photographs and how to organize your catalog just a little bit better to suit your needs. In this case, this is a quick example of how it would suit my workflow given my customer base or client base. Give us a thumbs up. Let us know what you think below or some stories or questions that you might have. We look forward and like reading them, and I'll see you in the next video and next time. Take care.